to my channel. I want to say a very big thank you to all of my subscribers, the old subscribers and the new ones. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, like my video, share my videos. Actually, if you actually find my video helpful, please do not hesitate to hit on the like button. Actually, hitting on the like button actually makes me to know you actually appreciate what I do. Actually, I've been getting lots of questions, video requests. Today, this is one of the requests on how to actually take a proper measurement for a bustier blouse. Because most times, when I see people out there, you see they make bustier dresses, you find out that some parts of the bustier dresses are hanging, and I'll be wondering what the reasons are. But most of them, actually, they don't know the reasons. I'll just be looking at the mistakes and be wondering if I could just grab them and just tell them, please do this and do this. So today, actually, I'm actually going to be taking a proper measurement for a bustier blouse. This measurement will actually help you to understand when you actually go with this measurement, when you measure this part for a bustier blouse, there's no way you go wrong with that bustier blouse. That bustier blouse will actually fit perfectly on the body. To fit, it will definitely fit perfectly. So that's what I'm actually going to be doing today, taking a proper measurement for a bustier blouse. So that is what I'm gonna be doing today. So let's go. All right, welcome back, guys. As you can see what she's putting on now, this is actually a bustier blouse. This is actually a six pieces bustier blouse, but you can still use it. The measurement can still go for a peplum bustier blouse. It can still go. So I'm actually gonna be using this as a mold to teach you how to actually measure it. The first thing you will measure when you're measuring a bustier, if I want to make this dress and I want to measure and I want the measurement to be perfect, you can see how perfect the dress is on her. You can see how it fits properly and perfectly. So I'm actually going to be measuring her now for this dress for you to see. The first thing I'll do, I'll take my tape and start from the shoulder. This is the shoulder. And then when I take my tape, the first point is the breast point. And then this is the breast point, you can see, which is the nipple. That is 11 inches. That's the first point you take. The breast point, which is 11 inches. Then the under bust, you can see this is the under bust. That's where the breast ends. So, which is 15. So now when you are writing, you say the breast point for this measurement is 11 and then 15. 11, 15. That's the first one. That's the breast point. Then the next thing I'll measure, after measuring the breast point, the next thing I'll measure is the under bust. The under bust, that's exactly here. You just take your tape like this and then you come. Don't do this. You don't do this. That's wrong. You just take your tape like this and then you come. You come like this and then you measure. For this, you make it, I normally make it very fit. I make it fit. For this, you can see I have 31 inches. I have 31. I'll just take it to the side like this and then place it. You can see it. I have 31 inches here. So that's it for the under bust. Then the next thing I'll do now is the bust circumference. That's the bust. That's the bust measurement. So I'll take it. That's the second measurement. The third one is the bust measurement. I'll just take my tape like this and then I'll place like this. And then you do this. Make sure it fits properly. You see it? What I actually have here now is 38 inches. So you do this and make sure it fits. It runs across. That's 38. Then the next thing I'm going to be doing now is the bust span. The bust span for any bustier, this is, if you miss it, the bust, the bustier will not fit properly. You can see the lines on this dress. It fits, it runs straight from the midpoint of the breast. So you take your tape like this for the bust span. You put it from one of the nipple and then to the other. As you can see, for this, I have 8 inches. This is the bust span. That is what they call bust span in bustier, but most people at times they don't know this is the bust span. So that is the bust span. That's the other one. Then the next thing I'm going to be measuring now, I'm going to be measuring from the top of the chest, which is the chest line. I'm actually going to be measuring, most times from the chest line is usually 8 inches. from the shoulder to your chest line is usually 8 inches. Then the next thing I'll measure, I'll just take my tape like this for a bustier, because if you want it to actually fit properly here, the next thing I'll do, I'll take my tape like this on top of the bust, the chest line, I'll take my tape like this from one armhole to the other. I'll take it like this and then measure. You can see it. I'll measure, because with this, you see the dress will fit perfectly. You see, I have 14 inches here. I'll measure and then bring it down a bit again like this, and then measure. When I measure from here, now I have 15 inches. Just put it on top, almost on top of the breast, and then you measure. You have 15. With this, you will never go wrong. Then the next thing, measurement I will take again is the shoulder. And then for the shoulder, what I normally do, I'll take it like this from the calf of the shoulder to this other side. I'll measure. For this, I have 13 inches. That is the shoulder measurement. This is how I normally do mine, and it works perfectly well. And then the next thing, the next measurement I'm gonna be taking now is the waist measurement. So most times, what I normally do in order to get the waist measurement properly, I normally take my tape and then I just don't assume where the waist is. I'll take my tape like this, I run it from here, and then ask my client, where is your navel? Please touch it. Your belly button. This is her belly button. So I normally take it like this. I normally take it like this. I will ask them and then take it like this. And then when I get here, I know that I have 19. That is at 19. Then I'll now measure the circumference of the belly button side. I'll take it like this. I'll take my tape like this and then measure like this. This enable me get the actual waist measurement. You understand? This actually helps me to get it right. I get it right. I'll just measure it like this, take it to the side, and then I'll make sure it fits properly. Then the next thing I'm gonna be doing now, that's for the waist measurement. Then the next thing I'm gonna be doing, I'll take the tape like this and then measure the length of the blouse. And I normally ask the client how long you want it. If they choose something that is too small, this is that's where you come in as the professional. So you advise them on what to do. You tell them either the blouse is too long or it's too short. You just advise them, and then you take the full length of the measurement of the blouse. And then for the sleeve, you come to the shoulder. For the sleeve, you come to the shoulder like this. You put your tape like this. Depends on the sleeve. For this kind of sleeve, this short pencil sleeve, you take it. The first thing you do is for you to take the length. When you take the length, this is one. At time you find that people, you see that the sleeve is usually so tight that they cannot actually raise their hands. So when you, after taking the length of the sleeve, the next thing I'll take my bicep. I normally put my tape like this and then measure up to this midpoint, which is 5 inches, and then take my tape like this and then measure this point. I'll measure it and then ask them how tight they want it. And then this is at 5 inches, because I started from here to here. This is 5 inches. At 5 inches, I actually have 13. And then I continue again. I'll take my tape again. With this, you get your sleeve. It will be perfect. With this, then I'll come down a bit again to the bicep. This is 9 inches. At 9 inches, and then I'll measure again at 9 inches. And then I'll get my accurate measurement. Then I'll take my tape again and get to the ending part of the sleeve. Depends on where the sleeve is. This, when you get to the elbow, I'll normally measure to the elbow again and then take the round of the elbow again. I'll take it like this and then take it. Depends on how long the sleeve is. If it is a three-quarter sleeve, I'll take it to this point again and then measure the round part. I'll just write them at 5, at 9, at 13, and then get my measurement. Then the next thing I'll do for the armhole, I'll just take my tape like this and then measure like this for my armhole. I normally take my tape like this and then I'll measure my armhole. I'll measure it round. With this, when you do this, you can never go wrong. Like I say, you can never go wrong. Your dress will fit perfectly well, and it will fit perfectly well. So this is how you actually measure for a bustier. And if it is a peplum, if it is a cut one like this, this is a peplum, but it is not cut. This is straight cut, which is a 6 pieces peplum. Then if it is the peplum that you cut, you measure. When you get to this point, when you measure, you ask them where they actually want the cut of their peplum to be. Like if they want it at 17, if they want the cut to be here, just or a little below the under bust. If they want it at 16, when you get to 16, you put your hand there on the 16 point and then take your tape and then you measure the round, which is the circumference. You measure it, so this will not enable you when you cut your peplum, the peplum will not be too tight and then it will not be too bogus. You measure that exact point where you want the cut of your peplum to be. So that is it. With this, when you do this, you will never go wrong with your measurement. So as you can see, that is, this is actually how you measure for your bustier. It's simple and easy. Once you do this, and like I told you, I've been trying it, I've tried it, and that is what I've been doing. And most of my clothes, not even most, all of them, they always fit perfectly well. You don't have to just whatever. So I've actually come to the end of this video. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe. If you actually find this video helpful, please do not hesitate to hit on the like button. So thank you so much for watching, and bye. God bless you.